Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next technique in error detection and correction is the Hamming code. So with the help of this Hamming code structure, we can detect errors. At the same time, we can correct the error also. Whatever the sender sends a message, if the receiver didn't receive the exact message, means there is a something error will be there. That error can be found by using the Hamming code. And we can also correct that error also. So this Hamming code, it can be applied to data units of any length. It can be applied to data units of any length. And it is used to detect and correct single bit errors. It is used to detect and correct single bit errors. Okay, now let us see the Hamming code structure, how it look like. Hamming code structure. The one thing you have to remember that if you're going to write the Hamming code structure, the all bit positions that are the power of 2 are marked as a parity bit. First thing is, we have to remember that all bit position that or power of 2 means like 1, 2, 4, 8, 10, like that 16. So if all bit positions that are power of 2 are marked as parity bits, that is 2 power 0, 1, 2 power 2, 4, 8, so on. So other bits, the remaining bits, the other bits are for data to be encoded. That is total the 7 bits. So the Hamming code structure can be constructed by using this point. You have to remember this point. All bit positions that are power of 2 are marked as a parity bits, and the remaining bits are occupies the data unit. So this is how the structure will like. Let us take the D7, D6, D5, and the power of 2, that is a 4, will occupy the parity bit P4, D3, and the second position P2, P1. So if you take the 7-bit Hamming code structure, so the 7-bit Hamming code structure will look like this. P1 is a parity bit, P2 is occupies parity bit, and D3 is the data bit that is occupied, P4 is a parity bit, D5, D6, D7 are the other data bits. So now let us determine the value of the parity bit. How we are going to determine these values? Determine the value of parity bit. So we already know about the data bits. The data bits means whatever the sender is sending, the receiver will receive that, means that data bits the user has given. So we know the data bit value, but we don't know about the parity bits value. What is the value of the parity bit? So that we have to be calculated. The rule is, the value of parity bit is determined by the sequence of bit, that is alternately check and skips. Let me write the rule first. If you want to calculate the value of parity bit, you have to follow this rule. The value of parity bit is determined by the sequence of bits that is alternatively checks and skips. What is this checks and skips? So I understood the value of parity bit is determined by the sequence of bits that are alternatively checks and skips. So let's see this. Let us take a simple example. The sender wants to send a message. The receiver is going to receive that message. So the sender is sending a 4-bit of data, 1101. So by using the Hamming code structure, we are writing the 7-bit Hamming code structure. D7, D6, D5, P4, D3, P2, P1. So we know the data bits. The data bits are 1, 1, 0, 1. Because in these positions, in the data bit positions only, it occupies the space. And we don't know about the parity bits. What is the P4 and P2, P1, we don't know. So let us calculate the values of parity bits. Let's take the P1. First we calculate P1. So I am saying that the value of parity bit is determined by the sequence of bit that is alternately checks and skips. So what we have to do? We have to check one bit, skip one bit. Again check one bit, skip one bit. Like that we have to be continue. So check one bit means one is checked and skip one bit. So two was skipped and write three. So three was checked and four was skipped, check five. Six was skipped, seven check, like that. Again like that. So for P1, the values may be 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, like that. And for P2, the formula for P2 is, the rule is, check 2 bit, skip 2 bit. Because this is P2. Again check 2 bit, skip 2 bit. Like that you have to be right. So check 2 bit means, first you have to write 2. 2 I checked. So after 2 I have to skip 2 bits. Means 3, 4 I have to skip. Means check 2 bits. 2 bits I have to check means start with 2. 2, 3 I checked 2 bits. Now skip 2 bits. Means 4, 5 I have to skip. Again check 2 bits. Means I have to write 6, 7. So 2 bits I checked. After that again I have to skip 2 bits. So 6, 7, after 7, 8, 9 I have to skip. Again I have to write 10, 11. So this is check 2 bits, 2, 3. In between this I skipped 2 bits. That is 4, 5 I skipped. Again check 2 bits, 6, 7 I checked. And skip 2 bits. That is 8, 9 I skipped. 10, 11 checked. Next 12, 13 skipped. 14, 15 checked. Like that. So this is for calculating for P2. Now let us write P3. For P4, check 4 bits, skip 4 bits. Because this is P4, so you have to check 4 and skip 4. Again check 4 bits, skip 4 bits. Like that continue. So check 4 bits. Start with 4. 4, 5, 6, 7. 4 bits are checked. So I had to skip 4 bits. Means 8, 9, 10, 11. Those 4 bits have to skip. Again I had to check. So start with 12, 13, 14, 15. 4 bits are checked. Now skip 4 bits. 16, 17, 18, 19 bits are skipped. So again write 4 bits, check 4 bits, 20, 21, 22, 23, like that. So this is how to rule for determining the parity bits. So then what will be the parities? P1, let me show you this. So this is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So P1, this is D3, first one is P1, D3, D5, D7, okay. Next P2, D3, D6, D7. I am writing up to 7 only because I taken only the 7-bit Hamming structure. So now P4. So what will be the value for P4? P4, D5, D6, D7. Okay, so we don't know the P1 value, so we have to calculate that. But we know D3, D5, D7. What are the D3, D5, D7? D3 value is 1, D5 is 0, D6 is 1, D7 is 1. So just copy that. P1 is 1, 0, 1. So 1, 0, 1, you'll get even numbers. So P1 is 0. If you get the even parity, P1 indicates the 0. Odd means 1. Now calculate P2. What is the value of D3, D6, D7? D3, D6, D7. All are 1s. 1, 1, 1. So now P2 is, because odd number of 1s, then P2 becomes 1. Now calculate P4. D5, D6, D7. What is the value of D5, D6, D7? 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1. So now value of P4 is even number of 1s. So P4 is 0. If even number of 1s are there, parity bit is 0. If odd number of 1s are there, parity bit is 1. So we calculated the P1 value, P2 value, P4 value. So this is how you have to determine the values. So now the complete structure is, the sender will send the message to the receiver like this. So this is P1, P2, D3, P4, D5, D6, D7. So after Hamming code, data is transmitted. It is decoded at the receiver end to get the data back. So the sender is sending this data with the help of this Hamming code, the parity bit. So then the receiver will receive the data by decoding the whatever the transmitted message at the receiver side. So this is how you are just sending the Hamming code. So now we have to decide how we are going to detect the error. So I send this message to the sender. So whatever the sender sends the message by adding the Hamming code technique, is the receiver receives the exact the same message or not? So that we have to be detected by using the same Hamming code technique. Now first let me explain the detecting error in the Hamming code structure. So let us consider a 7-bit Hamming code structure. So that is the D7, D6, D5, P4, D3, P2, P1. So let us take, at receiver's end, the bits are at receiver and bits 1, 3, 5, 7. This is the P1 bits. And 2, 3, 6, 7. These are the P2 bits. And 4, 5, 6, 7 are checked for even parity. Let us take all these whatever P1, P2, P4, all are even parities. Means all are zeros. If all 4 bits in this group, all 4 bits in these groups mentioned above process the even parity, then the receiver code is correct. So whatever the receiver receives the even parity, so okay, the data whatever the sender sends is a correct. If it does not contain any errors, suppose if parity is not even for any group of bits, then the error will be exited. That is how we are going to detect. If P1 is 0, P2 is 0, P4 is 0, then no errors. If any one of this bit is 1, then there exists an error. So this is how we are detecting the errors. Now, okay, I detect the error. One error is occurred because I received some odd parity. Now, how I am going to correct that error? Let us see that. Correcting of errors. So whatever the message had sent in, that is not matching with the parity. Now I have to correct that error. I have to find out what is that exactly. An error is located by forming a 3-bit number out of 3 parity checks. So first we have to find out what exactly in which position the error was occurred. So after that we have to correct that error. How I am going to solve that? Let us see that. So first, an error is located by forming a 3 bits, that is the out of 3 parity bits, P4, P2, P1. Let us take that. Finding P1. Let us take finding first the finding. Finding P1. So first we need to check. We check parity of P1, D3, D5 and D7. So the P1 parity is finding out by using D3, D5 and D7 bits. If it is odd, error exists. If the value of D7, D5, D3, if you get the all ones, then or single one, you get odd parity. That is P1 is 1. Suppose it is an even, no errors. No errors indicates P1 is equal to 0. Similarly, we check all the parities P2 and P4. So after we have found the error words, we find its decimal value. So similarly, find out P2 and P4. After we have found the error word, so with the help of this parity bit, if I found the error word, we find its decimal value. So for this binary, this is a binary. So suppose P1 is odd. Odd means it is something like P1 is odd and the bits are 1, 1, 1 like this. D3, D5, D7. So this is a word which consisting of error. Okay. And the P1 is 1 indicating. So this is a word which contains the error. So we have to find the decimal value for this binary value. First you have to find the decimal value. So after finding the decimal value for this binary error word, the value obtained tells the bit where error exists exactly. Then we invert the correct incorrect bit to obtain this correct word. Suppose this is, let us take this is the 7th. So in the 7th bit position, error was occurred. So just replace the data which is present in the 7th bit position. So that is the D6 value, that value has to be change. We have to be invert it. So then we invert the incorrect, that is the 7th position bit, to obtain the correct word. So this is how you are going to correct the errors. So I'll just explain this, how we are going to detect the errors and correct the errors by using the Hamming code technique with an example. So that I explain the next video. So then you will understand exactly how this correction of errors and the detection of errors can be identified and solved by using Hamming code technique. Thank you.